So I'm going to go ahead and drill
mounting holes. See if I can get it to align properly and what it looks like when it's bolted down. There's tension on the piece, and so when you bolt it down, it flexes a little bit. So I got to see what that looks like. I got to know. Pretty Allen heads as the mounting screws. So that's part of it now, huh? We're bolted down. I'm ready to start fiberglassing, and what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to mount it on the ball, kind of maybe just tape it with some duct tape, and then I'm going to set the ball inside a hole inside this box and then use this 10-pound weight to hold it stable and then lay the fiberglass on it and build the layers, and I'll work on the front first. Yes. Yeah. So this ball is.
What does it feel like?
You can touch it. Want to pick it up? Just hold it. All right. And then I'm going to put this weight inside the box.
Why?
That'll keep the box from moving around.
All right. We're getting in close on this, Ava. I'm going to use an eraser, or I mean a pencil, to mix. And then we're going to use a brush. You get what now? Yeah, you throw it away afterward, so the pencil's going to be wasted. Once I do this, there's no turning back. So if I ruin it, I got to start all over again. So what I'm going to do is blank it. I need to trim this. This is a caustic and very sticky solution. You do not want to get it on your skin, but if you can avoid it. Pour it in there. Woo, you smell it? Yep, it comes out really slow. It's not like water, it's thick. That's good. Perfect, perfect. Now what I need to do is put in the hardener. Thank you for pouring that. You know, I'm not exactly sure how much to put in, so I'm just gonna eyeball it. But I've gotta mix the hardener in. Ah. I hope I don't get any on my GoPro, that'd be terrible. It doesn't come off. All right, see, I'm mixing it. What this will do is cause
that.
It'll cause this stuff to start hardening.
Yeah. It'll stick to the pencil.
Oh, yeah, it's going to stick to the pencil. Pencil's gone after this. It'll just have this hard blob of fiberglass on it.
Can I see what it looks like, though?
Right now, it's just wet. See that? Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to try to spread it on now. Hopefully, that's stirred well enough. And hopefully, I put enough hardener in that it hardens.
It's okay if it sticks to the box, though.
Yes. Yeah, everything here is disposable. It's okay if it gets on the ball. I'll get you a brand new ball. Okay. It's gonna be a messy process, and I gotta move fast before this stuff hardens. Now we're gonna put this over this. More fiberglass.
I hope that stuff made your hands itch.
No, this isn't like fiberglass insulation. This is different stuff. Oh, I hope we don't run out here.
It's cool looking.
Yeah, I think it'll be really neat when it's done. It takes a while. It's really ugly in the first phases. And as you work the fiberglass...
It doesn't look so pretty right now.
No, it'll get better.
I like when things harden. They look cool.
Yeah, this will get really hard.
Like glass.
And then I've got to sand it.
It looks
it's called
like
fiberglass.
When this stuff dries, I'll be able to sand the fiberglass. And then it'll be a layer on top of the steel.
You'll get to cut around it?
Yes. Yep. I'll cut all this loose fabric out here off into this, around the shape. And then see, there's little air bubbles here that I can't get this to lay flat. But it's okay, because after this first layer dries, I'll go through this thing and remove anything that didn't stick and put another few coats of fresh fiberglass. There's a bubble. All right, I'm going to stop playing with it. It's not going to be perfect. I'm going to obviously have to do more coats, more layers. I'm going to have to do a separate strip here just to get it to stick, because this stuff's not laying down
flat. I noticed you're using Eva's ball to hold it up.
Yeah, that's all I got. And it's also holding its shape. It needed to stretch open a little
bit. But you said if it gets any fiberglass on it, you would get me a new
one. I sure will. And it did get a lot of fiberglass on it. Okay. So I'll have to get you a new one. But hey, that's step one, guys. We did a coat of fiberglass. All right, let's go. Thanks for coming and visiting.
Okay.
I love you guys.
Maybe for my birthday, you could get me a new ball.
So this is looking pretty solid. It's attached pretty well.
She's free!
Now we gotta see if we can extract it from the ball. We did. So I'll take some time, next step, to cut this out. I'm not going to do it tonight. It's the middle of the night. I just came down to stoke the fire, but wanted to check it out. Still let it cure more. It looked pretty good. I think it attached really well. I can even see right there there's an air bubble. So as I sand this out, I'm going to find probably some pockets like this one that didn't adhere to the metal. And I'll just add another layer and continue to build it up as it's solid. I don't want to go too thick. I want to make this as thin as possible. Fiberglass can get heavy in a hurry as you just pile it on. So we'll sand it and see what it looks like, add patches where needed, and keep building until it is shaped and smooth and ready for paint. I'll even use a little bit of Bondo and glazing putty to make it like a mirror finish. You shouldn't be able to tell that it's a handmade piece when I'm done. Sounds like plastic. Cool. All right, back to bed.